we know, there are known knowns.
There are things we know. We also know there are known unknowns. That is to say, we know there are some things we do not know. But there are also unknown unknowns. The ones we don't know, we don't know.
Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, in recent days, there has been a good deal of discussion about who bears responsibility for the terrible activities that took place at Abu Ghraib. These events occurred on my watch. As Secretary of Defense, I am accountable for them, and I take full responsibility.
I would add, however, that I think that the Department of Justice investigation into the CIA operatives who were involved with enhanced interrogation techniques is a most unfortunate thing. These people were operating at the direction of the president. They were doing things that had been approved by the Department of Justice, and it sends a chill throughout the government in terms of not just the CIA people, but also the military people, that they're going to have to get lawyered up if they do something.
What do you make of the statement made by the Iraqi government, yesterday that Iraq has no weapons of mass destruction and is not developing?
They're lying. Next. No, they have them and they continue to develop them, and they've weaponized chemical weapons. We know that. They've had an active program to develop nuclear weapons. They, it's also clear that they are actively developing biological weapons. I don't know what other kinds of weapons would fall under the rubric of weapons of mass destruction, but if there are more, I suspect they're working on them as well, even though I don't happen to know what they are.
But there are also unknown unknowns. The ones we don't know, we don't know.
We know they have weapons of mass destruction. We know they have active programs. There isn't any debate about it. So the idea that if you had an appropriate inspection regime, that they'd come back and say you were wrong is so far beyond anyone's imagination that it's not something I think about.
I really like the known unknowns part of it. And then he's like, they have chemical weapons, biological weapons, other weapons that I don't even, I can't even, conceive of them. But like, we know that if they're out there, they're working on a giant machine that just spits on people. And whatever happens, happens. And
and there's this guy who keeps stopping up his toilet there in Baghdad. We got to get him.
I don't understand the impulse of looking at this guy and saying, I'm gonna have the most likable man in the United States, most likable actor in the United States, play him in a movie. I've always wondered about the choice of having Steve Carell play him in Vice, and it's
he did a good job though. It's just I think there's something extremely vacuous about Rumsfeld, and there's that perfect moment in Vice where he's like, so what are our politics? What do we believe in? And Steve Carell just looks at him blankly because, you don't believe in fucking anything. So I think Steve Carell playing him wasn't a bad choice.
Brilliant. Because Carell, plays that idiot character so well, he's completely clueless and is not worth, he shouldn't have the job that he has. And that's always that's just Steve Carell. I mean, not him personally, but that's the character he plays best.
Yeah.
And so I've never really watched The Office, but from what I've seen from The Office and some of his movies, he's this kind of hapless idiot who's in these situations and just goes along with it as things get more and more ridiculous. And that is Donald Rumsfeld.
Yeah. Well, The Office, he's the one that usually causes things to get more and more ridiculous. I think in the case of, in the case of the Bush administration, and he served under Nixon. He served, I think, at one point under Reagan. He served throughout a whole bunch of different. And he was a senator, I think, for a little bit too, right? Or a congressman. I think that this kind of careerist haplessness, and then at the end of it, nobody is really punished for it. You know what I mean? He's kind of like the one of the people pushed out the most over the lack of brain trust.
And gets off scot-free.
I
mean, I have a question about that. Like, I and again, like this could, I guess, even bring us back to the movie whenever we could, you know. But like the idea of how much an individual is to blame is like an interesting question, because like in leftist circles, we try not to like make the individual be as accountable of one's own actions. But in the case of like someone who's got power, this individual absolutely knew what the hell he was doing. And at every step of the way, and like that's why I felt like the comparison with Steve Carell, it is a very, I feel like in a kind of way, sanitizing comparison, because Steve Carell at the end of the day, in doing all of this, doesn't really even bear accountability for his actions. He's hapless. He can't help it. Like, you know, mm-hmm. why would you put him in that position? So it's the John Mulaney joke about Trump all over again. But like in this guy's case, the evil is like pretty, you know, it's deliberate. It's a person committing these acts, knowing full well, especially the known unknowns and unknown unknowns. He knows exactly how much bullshit he's giving and like exactly what the consequence of that bullshit is. And in those circumstances, like how much is the individual to be held accountable? And I feel like Steve Carell is like the perfect character who kind of takes away. That's why like you're even able to love Michael Scott despite his like, you know, kind of all of the shit that he pulls, because at the end of the day, you kind of ask like, well, like, you know, it's his circumstances. He's just a simple guy who comes from these kind of XYZ contexts, and that's how we excuse them.
Yeah, well, I think the thing about Michael Scott is he's the perfect middle management. You know what I mean? Like, he isn't in the office responsible for any of the corporate like decisions, and he's kind of just you know, he might be the king of his little castle there, like, you know what I mean, trying to get everybody around him to like him. And you know, and that's the thing I think is likable about Michael Scott, is he's trying so desperately to get everyone to like him that it's like so awkward in the end that you're like, Jesus fucking Christ, like, all right, like, you know what I mean, like, we like you, I guess, like. But you know, with Donald Rumsfeld, I don't think he gave a fuck if anybody liked him, and that was a big part of it. But also, you know, in Vice, at least, like that era of you know, of his career, he was the middle management once again. You know what I mean? Like, he was kind of like, I don't think anyone would put him in that position, like, in, you know, in any of the previous administrations he served in, just like until the Bush administration. Like, I don't think he had that amount of power. He's just kind of like this bureaucratic, like, vacuous, abhorrent person, but, you know, not the person running policy. In the Bush administration, you know, obviously those people who had, you know, worked their way through that middle management section of the White House were now in control of it, very much looking to, you know, do the worst damage they possibly could in that case. All right. Well, so the known unknown things I liked, because it perfectly leads us into talking about Kiss Me Deadly.